So yeah, using torch.compile is actually pretty simple as we have seen, it's just one line of code. So actually, let's try this out in practice and see if it benefits our model training and if it can make our model train faster.
So yeah, we are going to take the same code that we used for unit 9.1 when we trained the model with mixed precision training. Now we are only adding this one line of code to compile our model using torch.compile. So let's scroll down to the relevant part here where we instantiate the model here in this case. And the only thing we have to do now is essentially to compile the model. So we do model equals torch.compile. There are of course also a lot of additional settings, but usually the default is quite okay. So let's run this and see how long it takes. So for reference, in unit 9.1, it took about 7.2 minutes. Let's now see if that's any faster. So I'll also show you maybe while it's training the trainer configuration. So we are training on one GPU using mixed precision training as before, and we are also training for three epochs like before. And yeah, usually the longer you train, the more benefits you will get from compilation, because the initial compilation takes also some time. So there might be some overhead that you are introducing when you are using the compilation. So usually the longer you train and the bigger your model, the more you will benefit from compilation. All right, as we can see, the training finished in 3.7 minutes, which is pretty fast. It's almost half the time that it took before. So in this case, compilation definitely made a difference, which is nice.
So in this video, we have seen how we can use torch.compile to make our model train slightly faster, which is pretty nice.